By the way, we've got a live-action swinging club going that maybe a few people haven't heard about. It's a result of my favorite line, booze is the only answer. Thus far, you should all be eligible for membership. If not, try one straight. It's strictly a fun club. And we've got chapters all over the world holding regular meetings. No joke, this beauty really has caught on. We had a meeting in Fort Lauderdale, and we made this special recording. It's uninhibited conversation between audiences and myself. Believe me, I tell you, it's completely unrehearsed, and being people just like you, they had a ball. You ought to get quite a belt out of this. Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and good morning to those of you who just got up. In this first annual message to all of you Batoans, you're going to discover something wonderful. People just like you really have a ball. We're recording live tonight from the Bahama Hotel here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Long drinks and short songs are the rule here in this sunny, fun-filled haven for happy hoochers. And here we go with our own Batoa International Anthem. Talk to many of the club members tonight, friends, just to get their views on a myriad of different subjects, the most important of which is a casual booze every 3 or 4 minutes. So I got a beautiful gal over here. Sandy, I understand you're a member of the club and you're pretty much of a positive thinker.
Well, yeah, that depends.
Tell me something. I just want to know this because we got a bunch of drinkers here. Not drunks, but drinkers. What's your honest opinion about going out and boozing, drinking, as long as you don't overdo it?
Well, like, I dig it. I mean, like, what else is there to say?
Hey, like, you're pretty far out, ain't you? I just like the way you talk, Sandy. And your husband is a doctor, is that right?
Well, he's my ex-husband.
Well, you know, most people get along better that way.
Matter of fact, talking about booze, I'm of the opinion that, you know, it's good for the liver. I mean, I think it, alcohol preserves the liver, but...
Yeah, I've seen a lot of livers in those jars, and they all got a... Yeah. Sandy, I think you're off on a hell of a tangent here. Now, just for the heck of it, now let's just go to the doctor, and let's just ask the doctor who's opposite you there. Doc?
Yes?
I'd like to know about that alcohol preserving that liver.
Well, it has many sterling qualities. There are approximately 100... tranquilizers available to the American public today, and I would say that alcohol is the oldest, the safest, and the cheapest in the long run.
Of the tranquilizers? Hey, how about that? Doctor, I appreciate your views relative to the tranquilizers, and we're certainly not trying to knock the tranquilizers out of action or anything else.
Why don't you ask him about his liver?
I feel my liver every morning. It's down around my right shin bone.
I read a thing by this doctor. He says, never feed your youngster milk before you put him to bed at night. He says, milk turns to butter. Butter turns to fat. Fat turns to sugar. Sugar turns to alcohol. You got a 6-year-old wakes up with a hangover in the morning. Hey, you're great. Stay happy, stay healthy, and above all... stay loaded. Now, you just go ahead and look at each other as you listen to this. Don't you think those people were having fun? And just so you won't worry too much about old Woody, I really don't think booze is the only answer. And I don't advocate wife beating while under the influence. I think you ought to sober her up first. And I sure as the devil don't believe in driving after drinking. But I do firmly suggest you learn to dodge the guy who does. Why don't you join our club if you haven't already? And for heaven's sake, tell your friends. Inside this record, you found a membership card. And you might just as well join, because it's for free. And you no need going through life cheating yourself out of the more laughable things. It's a great new movement.